नमस्कार मित्रों, माय सेल्फ सचिन नम्बर स्पीकिंग। आई डन माय बीटेक इन पेट्रोलियम इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम पंडित दीनदयाल पेट्रोलियम यूनिवर्सिटी। आई हैड क्रैक्ड गेट 2019 एंड हैड सिक्योर्ड ऑल इंडिया रैंक 15। करेंटली आई एम वर्किंग एज अ प्रोडक्शन इंजीनियर इन ONGC। सो फॉर टुडेज सेशन वी बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन डिक्लाइन कर्व एनालिसिस। सो बिफोर गेटिंग इन द सेशन लेट मी बी कूल। You may be very clear that this is a very important topic, and almost every year questions have been asked from this particular concept. So take a special note regarding that. Right. Now coming to the introduction part, the decline curve analysis, or commonly known as DCA, it's a graphical representation of the production data. Okay, and it is been used. It has been used for analyzing the decline production rate. It is also used for forecasting the future performance of oil and gas wells, all right, and to estimate EUR, which is also known as estimated ultimate recovery. We will discuss it in detail in the coming slides, right? Now come to this point. Note, so what you're doing basically over here is that they are fitting a line to the production data. Okay, we are obtaining some trend out of the production data, and we are assuming that the trend continues in the future. Pata nahi chala. Let me plot it graphically. See, we have a graph of Q versus time. Let us assume Q of oil, where Q is flow rate of oil in barrels of oil per day. Alright, and time, let's say in years. Okay, now we have some production data. Okay, now here's some production data. See, we have got some production data. This is oil. I'm plotting basically oil production data. I have time. Okay, iska matlab till here we have the data available with us. That means till here, till this point, we have the historical data available with us. Alright, now. What we are doing in decline curve analysis is we are trying to fit a line. See, we are trying to fit a line to the production data. Okay. Now, while fitting the line, we are getting some sort of trend. See, we are getting some sort of trend. Okay. Now, what we are using it is that we are using that particular trend to predict the future. Very simple. See, now we are predicting the future. See, that's exactly what this note is all about. We are fitting a line to the historical production data. We are getting some sort of trend, and by using that particular trend, we are assuming that we are trying to get the future production data. Very simple. Kuch nahi hai bhai. Okay. Now this particular decline in the production, this decline in production may be a function of declining reservoir pressure and change in volume of produced. Yeah. We all know that with time, that as you are producing the field, with time the reservoir pressure is gonna decline. Yeah, it definitely depends on the reservoir drive mechanism also. We will discuss the reservoir drive mechanism in detail in coming sessions. Okay, so coming to this point, reservoir pressure to decline hone hi wala with time, no doubt for it, no doubt regarding that. Okay, plus the volume of produced fluids we are getting up on the surface, that is also going to change, because as we know that oil, water and gas, you are not going to obtain that same particular rate at which it was producing initially today. It's going to change definitely, because it's a reservoir. It will change. Okay, everything changes, even the reservoir changes with time. So these two parameters is primarily responsible for the decline in production rate. Okay, all right. Now coming to the assumptions. Okay, while performing decline curve analysis, we are taking into consideration these four assumptions. Now this particular thing can be a very important question for GATE. Like some questions may be asked related, what are the assumptions of decline curve analysis? So this, I think according to me, these are the four assumptions that we take while performing decline curve analysis. Now, first point is drainage area is constant. As we all know that every well has some drainage area around it. Okay. We are assuming for this particular well, let's say it's in the perforation over here. For this particular well, it's a cylindrical drainage area. Okay. We also know that in the oil and gas industry, well spacing is a very big deal. Yeah. Okay. So placing two wells too close together may experience pressure interference and drainage overlap. See, let me discuss over here. Assume that it's a field. Okay. Now there is a well over here, well number 1 and well number 2. Okay. Now, for well number 1, this is the drainage area, and for well number 2, this is the drainage area. Okay. Since these two wells are very close to each other, you can see that there is an obvious overlap of drainage area. Plus, there would be some pressure interference also. We will be discussing this in well testing also. This concept will be repeated in well testing. Alright. So, So, this is the case when there are two wells very close to each other. Now, let's see. There are two wells very far away from each other. There is well number 1 and well number 2. Very, very far away from each other. This is the drainage area of this well number 1. And this is the drainage area of well number 2. Now, it's obvious that there will be no interference between these two wells, but the catch over here is these reserves is going unexploited. They are not able to exploit this particular reserve, these reserves. Okay, this area is completely unexploited. So what we need over here is we need another well over here. Ek aur well chahiye bhaiya beech mein to hi to production pura nikal sakte hai, hai na? So, this drainage area is a very important concept. Okay. Decline curve analysis, we are assuming it to be constant. That is, throughout the life of the well, the drainage area will remain constant. Okay. Alright. Done. Now, let me erase these things. Coming to second point, which is well produce at a constant flowing bottom well pressure. That means the well, it has been assumed that throughout its life the well will produce at constant flowing bottom well pressure. Matlab kya? Matlab dekhte hain. It's a well, it's a reservoir, it's a perforation. This is the reservoir pressure. And this is the flowing bottom wall pressure, FBHP. Okay. What we are assuming is that throughout the life of the reservoir, this particular thing will remain constant. Okay, it's an assumption. And as we all know, what is flowing bottom wall pressure? It's the hydrostatic pressure of the column of fluids. Fluids plus the back pressure that you are giving. Okay, this is the flowing bottom wall pressure. This is how you calculate from flowing bottom wall pressure. Okay. Coming to the third point, the skin factor is not changing with time. It has been assumed that the skin will remain constant throughout the life of the well. Now, what is skin? I will be discussing this particular topic in very much detail, but for as of now, let's see what the skin is. Skin is, let's say this is a well bore radius. This is the well bore radius RW. Okay. Now, near the well bore radius, there is a region of altered permeability. Okay. Near the well bore, there is a region of altered permeability. Okay. And because of that, this particular phenomenon of skin occurs. Okay. Permeability can be more than the original permeability or can be less than the original permeability. As we all know, if the original permeability is more than the K skin, then skin is positive, and if K original is less than K skin, that means it is the stimulated wells with skin less than zero. Going through the fourth point, pseudo steady state flow regime has been followed. Okay, pseudo steady state flow regime or a boundary dominated flow. That means it has been assumed that the well will be flowing under these regimes. Okay, and this is a very important point. It is not applicable for a transient flow regime. Not applicable for a transient flow regime. If at all, if you want to find if there are wells which are flowing in transient flow regime, then there are certain type curves that we can use to determine the decline rate or estimate the EUR. Okay, but coming to the limitation part of decline curve analysis, first point is any past activities like change in choke sizes or workover jobs will affect the future trend. Seedhi baat hai, theek hai. If the well has been gone, let me show it graphically. If I'm plotting Q versus time, see, let's say your well is with time, you are plotting flow rate of oil, BOPD. Okay, with time, see, well is going down. Over here, I've done some workover job. Okay, workover job. Let's say I've done an acid job. Assume. Okay. Because of workover, what happened is that now let's assume that that particular workover was a great success. This point, that is any past activities, will affect the future trend. What does it mean? That because of this workover job, the trend has been affected. Hana, you can see that in the graph also. So that's one point. Now second, if you're also changing the choke size, then also this particular trend will change. Let's say let me assume I am flowing, this is well number one. Okay, let me assume this is well number one. This purple color is well number one, and okay, this is the trend. Okay, this is well number one. Okay, with choke size of, let me say, 12 by 64 ka choke size mein ye maine run kiya. Now for well number two, with increased choke size of 20 by 24, okay, isme kya hoga? Theek hai, yaar isme kya hoga? Dekho, isme aapko production rate zyada milega, obviously zyada milega, but with time the rate of decline, भी बहुत ज्यादा मिलेगा, है ना? मतलब आपको बिकॉज आपने बड़े चोक से प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हो, सिंस यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग इट एट हायर चोक साइज, योर प्रोडक्शन रेट हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड डेफिनेटली, बट ऑन अ लॉन्ग रन द डिक्लाइन रेट हैज ऑल्सो इंक्रीज, तो वी आर कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग ऑन द डिक्लाइन रेट इफ यू आर ट्राइंग टू इंक्रीज द चोक साइज. ठीक है, दैट मीन्स पॉइंट इज क्लियर. Now, so if you are changing the choke size, let's say there is a well, right? This is, I'm again plotting Q versus time. Now I'm producing at higher choke, smaller choke rate over here, Now, till now I have produced with 12 by 64 choke. Now what I did is I have tried to produce it with bigger choke. Now what happened? Because since I have used the bigger choke, now I am drastically increased the production rate, but the decline has also increased. See, 20 by 64. I have compromised on the decline rate. Faster decline rate is there. Just an example. Okay. In absence of stabilized production rate, this technique is gonna give huge errors. Again, that particular thing we mentioned, that in transient state of the well, you cannot use decline curve analysis. That basically in transient state, the stabilized, you are not able to get that stabilized production rate. Okay, So yeah, it's almost the same point. It has been repeated over here, but in different kind of words. Coming to a type of decline curve analysis, type of decline curves. I will be discussing the concept or the theory given by Arps. By Arps, this guy gave the theory. According to him, there are three decline curves possible. That is exponential, hyperbolic, and harmonic. This is the equation, very important equation. Based on this particular equation, this guy has given the entire theory. So he's paying. So that according to him, So what is? Let's discuss about the variables in the equation. Over here, this minus d shows the decline rate. This b, small b, shows the hyperbolic constant. Q is the production rate. It has dq by dt means it has been differentiated with respect to time. As discussed by Arps, there are three decline curves according to him. One is exponential, hyperbolic, and see from the trend itself that this blue one is determined by harmonic. This is the harmonic one. The red one is the exponential, and the green one is the hyperbolic. Hyperbolic lies in this range between 0 and 1. This particular thing you can see over here. Now, one peculiar thing you can note is that as we are going from exponential to harmonic, the decline rate is comparatively less. Have you noticed it? I wanted to say is as b increases, as this value of b, this thing, this chotus of b, as this value of b increases, the curve becomes flatter. That means decline कम होता है. अगर जैसे जैसे b बढ़ता है वैसे वैसे आपका जो कर्व जो है फ्लैटर होते रहता है. दैट मीन्स आपका डिक्लाइन भी फ्लैट हो रहा है. आई हैव डिराइव्ड फॉर द एक्सपोनेंशियल डिक्लाइन. दैट इज फॉर एक्सपोनेंशियल डिक्लाइन b इज इक्वल टू 0. ओके. Now, as we all know the equation, as now as we all know the equation, as we are in the seen in the previous slide, what I've done is that I put b equal to 0, in the equation. Now, from that I got this, and then I put integral that is from 0 to time, integrated from 0 to time, qa to qa. That means what does this mean? At time t is equal to 0. I have qi, all right, and for time t equal to t, I have q. So once I've obtained this equation, I'm going to the cumulative production. Once I've obtained this particular equation, let's find q, capital Q. This is cumulative. To find the capital Q, what you have to do is very simple thing, very basic 12th standard mathematics. So you have this production data. What I did is that I found this area under the curve. Now if I am getting this area under the curve, then I will get the cumulative Q. That's exactly what I've did over here. That's exactly what I've done over here. So instead of this Q, I put this one. See, and if I'm solving it, then my cumulative Q would be this. वेरी सिंपल, वेरी सिंपल. कुछ ज्यादा कुछ नहीं है, बहुत आसान, बहुत आसान. तो दिस फॉर एक्सपोनेंशियल डिक्लाइन. दिस इज दिस टू यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इट. बाय द वे यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर फाइंडिंग यूर. इट इज द समेशन ऑफ क्यूमुलेटिव प्रोडक्शन, क्यूमुलेटिव प्रोडक्शन प्लस द रिमेनिंग रिजर्व्स, plus the remaining reserves as per the trend. Now let's look at this graph. This is rate versus cumulative gas production or time. It is applicable for time also. Since it is for cumulative gas production, you can see that till here it is already been produced. This q, I think from the last slide you will get qi minus q by d. This is the same thing. This is the same thing. तो यहां तक आपको दिस यू गॉट इट, राइट. नाउ for the remaining, you also, plus you also know the trend, you also know this trend, okay, you know very well this trend, okay. Now what I'm doing is I'm assuming the trend continues in the future and I'm getting the forecast. See, I'm getting the forecast. Now from the forecast, whatever I'm getting is the remaining, is my remaining reserves. That's exactly what UR is. Okay. So what's the significance of UR? What's the significance of UR in? Yes, it is used to estimate recovery. Recovery estimation at a specific economic limit. As of now, you have to remember that recovery factor is the ratio of UR versus initial all in place. The way we discussed for exponential, similarly we can get derive the real time cumulative and UR for hyperbolic and harmonic also. I would rather recommend that you all that you remember these equations, very important equations. In gate examination, you will be applying it directly while solving numericals. Now let us discuss how the typical value of B changes for different reservoir dry mechanism. Alright, I have here four different type of dry mechanism and their corresponding values that are generally obtained in the field. I am talking about the hyperbolic constant values, alright. So let me plot it graphically so that you guys can understand it. Again, Q versus time. Okay, now first let me plot for water drive. As we know, the water drive, the value of B is greater than 0.5. Let's assume this is my, this is for water drive. This is for water drive. Now for gas cap, it is around 0.5. So let this be for gas cap drive. For solution gas drive, it lies between the range of 0.1 to 0.4. Let this be a for solution gas drive. All right. And for rock and liquid expansion, it is almost zero. That means the decline is very high. Let this be for rock and liquid expansion. Rock and liquid expansion. Okay. So from this graph, we can very well, very clearly say that, as we had discussed before, as the value of B increases, the curve becomes flatter. See, so we can also say that with increasing B, the decline rate decreases. And particular presentation, you can also derive that for water drive, if the reservoir has water drive mechanism, then the wells will have comparatively lesser decline as compared to that of a gas cap or a solution gas drive. Alright, that's it for today. Hope you all have enjoyed the session. Let me be very clear that this particular platform, the Petrogyan, we will be posting videos which are completely free. Anyone can access it. And so please support us by liking, sharing and commenting on our YouTube channel. Please subscribe to the channel and follow us on Instagram and Facebook. Thank you.